The Essential Education Projector Range from Hitachi sponsors ICT programs.
Essere attivo vi mantiene in buona salute, quindi esercizio.
Perché gosto di correre, o resto dos rapazes gostam de jogar
futebol.
Something is happening out there in cyberspace. The world is talking, the world is vlogging. From Baghdad to Boston, Birmingham to Beijing, people are writing weblogs. It is communication and publication for the people. Some say it's changing the world. It's already changing some of our schools. For young converts, it's the best way to communicate.
My family abroad in Iraq are able to read it, and then they phone us, and I had a phone call yesterday saying, well done, and they're happy with the progress I'm making.
You know that people can actually see the work that you've done, rather than you're just basically keeping the work to yourself in your exercise book.
I'm Steve O'Hare, and like many people who work in new media, I've made up my own job title. I call myself a digital evangelist, and that can mean many things, but what it does mean is that I try to get the most out of technology. I'm a big fan of blogging, and I think it has an important role to play in education. So what is blogging? At its simplest, a weblog is an online journal or personal webpage where you can publish your thoughts and observations, link to other websites, and put up your pictures. The key thing is that you can publish your work to a potential 600 million internet users around the world. A lot of people think blogging may well have a role in all of our lives in the future, and the next generation is already getting started. I'm off to see the pioneers. Here in West Blatchington, a primary school in Hove, West Sussex, they believe it's never too early to start blogging. Blogging is encouraged throughout the school. The head is a convert and even writes his own blog.
Children are interested in computers, but mainly for playing games. This way we've got them involved in the computers, particularly to communicate by words, by pictures. I've seen children using change of font, change of style, inserting hyperlinks, inserting pictures. This has actually got the children going, particularly some of the boys and some of those who don't like writing.
It's not like boring, like in the middle of a literacy lesson, writing up a story in the middle of your book or something and then getting bored and arms start aching and stuff like that.
It's stimulating for children. It gets them involved and learning without them appearing to do so.
Blogosphere, the worldwide community of bloggers.
The pioneer and blog master at West Blatchington is John Mills.
I first came across weblogs in 2001 when I worked at the British School of Amsterdam in Holland. There's a guy there called Peter Ford, who was my ICT coordinator at the time, and he set up the first batch of junior school weblogs in Europe. When I came back to England, it seemed natural that I'd be the first teacher in Britain to set them up.
What strikes me first is the enthusiasm the pupils bring to their blogging. It's a great outlet for their passions.
Basically, our blog is about anything funny. We have jokes, funny websites. This is like one of our favourite jokes which we got.
Eat up your greens, they are good for your skin. But I don't want green skin.
I chose wrestling because I've got loads of matches and loads of facts on tape, so I could use loads of information. Here's one or two facts for an example. Goldberg, 150 matches in a row, and no one else has done that. And Triple H is closest to beating that record with 137 matches in a row.
Why didn't Cinderella get into the soccer team?
Because she runs away from the ball.
This is our web blog. It's called About Fantastic Football.
We're doing a web blog about pop stars, and this is our McBlyde page.
Bloggeria, uncontrolled outpourings of blogging.
pupils love having an outlet and an audience.
The main advantage that I see through weblogs is that it gives children a voice. They're aware that they have a readership because they constantly look at the stats they're receiving, the hourly hits they're receiving.
Last time I looked at it, I had 213 people looking at it.
It just encourages them to write with greater accuracy.
If you made a mistake in your book, you might not spot it, but if you made it on the weblogs, you can delete it.
Their ICT skills have shot up through the roof. They've been on a very steep learning curve. When I started Weblog Club, the children couldn't open two internet pages at once.
When we first started using weblogs, we were quite nervous and something. We learned how to do it by Mr. Mills. We felt more confident.
Where blogging really seems to score is in bringing out children who are unsure of themselves for whatever reason. Mohammed came from Iraq.
At first I was like quite shy and I was quite worried because people might not think it's good, but now everyone helps us, so I'm starting to get more confident.
First language was Bengali, but when I first came into school, it was quite hard to like talk and write English and these things. And when I did the blogs, it was quite hard to do it. Now it's really easy to do it, and it's really fun to do it.
They've been happy being on this steep learning curve because they're so desperate to publish themselves.
Blogarati, the cream of the blogging world.
Now, sceptics might say that blogging isn't really any different from, say, producing a school magazine or putting work up on the wall. But I think it offers something very different. Blogging is direct, it's instant, and most of all, pupils express themselves without having to go through an adult. Blogging can cover almost anything.
It spreads to every area of the curriculum, not just literacy. We've even got things like the Science Club. They're involved. They've put up their own blog so that the children can do some of the things they're doing in Science Club at home. We've even got links abroad now with a couple of teachers who went to New Zealand. They've involved the children via the blogs.
The After School Blogging Club, where it all started, remains one of the most popular extracurricular activities at West Blatchington.
I think the After School Club was a brilliant club to set up because a lot of people wanted to do it, and when Mr. Mills said in assembly who would like to do it, the whole school raised their hand.
Sometimes we get other animation from like official websites and stuff.
Yeah, and we do a hyperlink where you click on the picture, you go back to the website. Well, we just get information of it and we just share it, like take it in turns to do typing, take it in turns to use the mouse. We just tell each other if we got any information, we just type it up.
And it's nice in the club to know if you'll get stuck, you know that your friends are there to help you with it as well.
From an after-school club, it's now a school-wide activity, and they even have blogging assemblies.
Right, so here is Greg's page that I know you've been working on this week, very hard.
We set up a weblog at the fortnight assembly. And we expect an update every week, minimum every fortnight from each class.
The assemblies are really popular. It's great for me to see how blogging brings a whole school together.
We had an example this week where I went in to observe a lesson on 24-hour time in one Year 5 class. The following day, the other Year 5 class put up a special grid that would help those children in their learning.
We have been studying the 24-hour clock in numeracy.
We created a table showing how times can be written in 12-hour clock and 24-hour clock.
By having the assembly, it puts pressure on teachers to make sure the updates are there. And if that doesn't work, the children will certainly put pressure on the teachers, because they want to go up at the front of the assembly. They want access to the class weblog. They want to publish their work and talk about it, same as everyone else.
At every blogging assembly, they award a prize for the best class blog. It's presented as a very inclusive activity. It is particularly appreciated in the school's autistic unit. The team have found blogging a great tool to get the pupils to connect with the world and help them to express themselves. And it's just as popular here.
Do you like history?
Yes.
Right.
Staff have found that blogging gives the pupils extra motivation to do their work, something autistic spectrum children can lack.
If you click on it, you'll see...
Working with writing and pictures on a weblog can help the children organise their ideas better.
This is good. I like this one because...
Because I like to put pictures on my webpage.
Did you know if you click on a picture, you could go from one weblog to another?
Because it's more fun doing homework on the weblogs.
Blog you, a small nugget of information or opinion within a blog.
One of the biggest worries with children and the internet is security. How does the school deal with all the risks out there?
Well, firstly, the children are very aware what they're allowed to publish on the web, what they're not allowed to publish on the web. So, for example, they know that golden rule number one is not to give any details, any clues as to where they live. Even their surnames, nobody puts their surnames online.
Of course, through the school system anyway, we have a net nanny which makes sure that stuff doesn't go out that is unsuitable. And that's screened off by the LEA as part of the net watch.
Nobody's allowed to send any messages whatsoever to any of the weblogs run throughout our school.
The teachers have make sure people can't email you in case they say something horrible. I don't really feel worried that much because I know that people aren't going to email me.
The trouble is that blogging at its best is the work of many voices. Making the school a fortress to the outside world isn't perfect.
The downside of this is that it makes the communication within each weblog a one-way process. People can read it but then can't comment. We're going to solve this problem next year when we invite readers to send their responses to our work to an email address which only I will have access to, so I can then vet all responses, copy and paste suitable ones onto our readers' comments page, which will be available for everyone to see.
With two-way traffic, blogging helps keep people in touch with each other and with the wider world.
If more kids start doing this, it's going to be really good around the world.
Other people, like our families, can see it from other parts of the world.
My weblog's about countries because I've been to quite a lot of countries and I find it quite fun to write about what I did.
My family in Spain read it also, and they like it as well, and I occasionally get a phone call saying that well done and everything.
Because I've got family abroad, they don't get to see my work and they feel really proud when they see me working on the weblogs.
I don't think they would have progressed at all as quickly if they didn't have that audience there.
You get loads of people looking at it and then like you just loads of people begin to know you a bit better.
We might be famous.
The longer we have blogs in the school, I think we'll soon start to see literacy levels improving greatly.
Blogstipation, running out of things to say on your blog.
I don't think blogging is just a fad. It's here to stay. It's already changed the way we interpret our news and challenge our politicians. And I'm convinced it will have an important role in education. The story's only just begun. All I need now is to work out how I'm going to write this up in my blog.
Essential Education Projectors from Hitachi sponsor ICT programs.